Hello everyone, welcome to Symphony, the phonology of English all around the world.
I'm Kintara Akinuddin. Nice to meet you all. Hope you all have a good day and relax and enjoy with the show.
Yeah.
Before we begin, what are we going to discuss today?
So this is a podcast that will accompany you with fun and so much informative chats.
Yes.
So guess what is this? If you can't guess, you will get a low score.
Oh, that's so scary, right? Give me some time to think about this.
Well, I will give you 3 seconds.
We will discuss about a picture.
No, one.
About a movie.
Two.
About a video.
Three. Next. Over. Okay, you will get a low score, sorry.
Okay. What is it? Tell me.
Okay, but calm down.
Yes?
If you want to get a high score, it's easy. It's a simple thing. Yeah. Then, just listen to what we will discuss today. I will tell you what we wanna discuss now. This is one of the song from one of the band in Indonesia, yes. Namely Reality Club, and the title of the song is Anything You Want, and the topic is E in Reality.
Okay. Wow, it looks so fun, and I think we have a very interesting topic for discuss today, isn't it?
Exactly, it does, Rakin. Well. We also have some interesting stories and insight that will definitely broaden your horizons. So don't miss it.
Okay. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment below. Let's get started with our chat today.
So we are not just two of us here, guys.
Right. We will also be accompanied by someone popular.
So, can you guess who
can you
is
guess
he?
Who is he?
Who? Oh,
I don't know.
Well,
let's welcome Mr. Danny Sulaiman. Yeah. How are you, Mr. Danny?
I'm great, thank you.
You look so happy today.
Yeah, I'm very happy because of you. Oh. Yeah. With the students, always be happy.
Okay, but before we start our discussion, let's listen to the song that will be sung by the Diversity Choir.
Okay.
Check it out.
Check it out.
give an applause for the great one. Wow. This song is very good, right?
Okay. Of course. And also the performance by our class. Yes.
And it's suitable to listen with your loved one.
Okay, so
don't talk about personal.
just kidding, guys.
Still out, guys.
Okay. Don't be serious.
Okay.
So as we said earlier, today we are with someone who is popular. He is also our lecturer in English phonology and phonetic curse. Well, Mister, what do you know about this song?
Yeah, this is a new song for me, and I have to listen as we deal of our song here. And I exercise myself. I have to play bass here. And when I listen to the song, and I did enjoy the song. This is good for me to get my bass exercising.
Wow, it's interesting.
Interesting.
Well, according to you, what can we learn from this song?
Because the subject is phonology, so we can see, we can analyze about the sound inside the song. So that's why if in the classroom we talk about the short E, the long E, we can see the sound, the vowel, the consonant inside the song. Let's see the practice one.
Okay. So may you give us some example from the part?
From the lyric.
Yes.
Yeah, from the lyric, like I feel. Okay. If you know in the text, this is written by I feel. But in reality, you can sing I feel. So how many are long of the vowel? Okay. So this is not about the short E, the long E. But in I feel, probably there would be 3 to 4 beat in reality. That is the example.
I think it's, we can get new knowledge from a song, yes? Okay. Besides, we learn to listen. And I think it's a lot in the lyric we can explain. According to you, what lyric is interesting one for Mr. Daddy?
Well, as I see, we listen that we have to play the song with the refrain.
Yes.
The riff. The riff would be we talk about everything. Yeah, in reality, we have talk here with the long R and everything with the. Yeah, in phonology, we have the different culture in Indonesia, in culture. In English, we have the here, everything. If we learn A, B, C, D, F, G, as we teach to our generation, probably we cannot hear about the. You know, in our culture, like thank you. Yeah, when you were in senior high school, junior high school, you will say thank you with the thank you. But we know now that the exists in English. We talk about everything. The.
Well, I have one question. Maybe it's a kind out of the topic. I'm just confused about it.
Confused?
Yeah.
What is it?
There is a part that I can't disagree.
Okay, that's good.
It's a double. I think.
Yeah.
Yes.
Double negation.
Negation. And disagree.
Can't disagree. Yeah. Can't here is negative because can consist of can and not, and disagree consists of dis and agree. Yeah, based on intonation, ladies and gentlemen. We know that and I can disagree. So we have 5 syllables here. 5 syllables, I and I can disagree. So in this case, probably the songwriter need the syllable. Because it means that I agree. I can agree. But I can agree just 3 syllables. But in this song, we need 5 syllables.
Yes.
So I can disagree. And I think this is a good idea for us to learn.
Yes.
Because I can agree and I can disagree, different meaning. You can feel because you are studying English when you say I agree and I can disagree. So it means that someone force you, force you that you have to agree with the statement. I can disagree. Like, do you want this drink or beverage? Okay, sir, I can disagree. So it means I force you to agree to my statement.
Yeah, I see.
Mm-hmm. In this case, the song is one of the band in Indonesia.
Mm-hmm.
And what the different Indonesian people sing a song English song and
yeah, he means a pronunciation.
Yes.
Yeah, in the term of pronunciation, I think the songwriter has good English. And I believe that the songwriter is native voiced means he learned or they learned English and they do understand about English.
Oh, yeah.
And we can learn, as you said, this one, It's Fine by Me.
Yes.
Yeah. When you know in Indonesian culture, in our studying English, it's okay for me. Yes, for me. I agree, but it's fine by me. So we can learn, this is one phrase that you can habitualize your speaking by, it's fine by me.
Oh,
yeah. New phrase for you.
Mm. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay, it's so very interesting, right?
Yeah. Yes, of course.
I think many Indonesian have like this.
Yeah.
Yes.
And that is why English is discussed about English not in British, from Asia, Africa,
yes.
Latin America, we learn English. That's why the name is English. This is the discussion of English around the world.
You start from the Asia.
Start from Asia. And I don't know for the next one,
yes.
What continents, what countries. Let's see.
It's a secret. So stay tuned.
In this channel.
Okay.
So, thank you, mister. We can also find out other things. Like what was just said. We find about the grammar also.
Yes, about the phonology, the pronunciation, the different pronunciation of Indonesian people and
between people around the world.
Yes. Okay, people around the world.
Okay.
Thank you, Mr. Daddy.
Anytime.
And sorry.
And sorry for
for the mistake.
Yeah, for the mistake.
No,
this is our first experience.
Not need to say sorry.
Thank you, Mr. And this is the first episode, and next will be explained
another
song from around the world.
Stay tuned
and see you next time.
Yeah.